In our last video on Tepster's Tips, we discovered how Neanderthals' ancestors came out of Africa. Today, we'll discuss if, how, and why Neanderthals went to war with Homo sapiens. About 500 to 650,000 years ago, humanity split into two groups. One group stayed in Africa and became modern humans, while the other group, known as Homo Neanderthals, went to Asia and Europe. They are not our direct ancestors, except for some interbreeding, but they are sister species who evolved in some ways differently than us to survive in their new lands. At first look, it may seem like Neanderthals lived peacefully in their environment and with each other, but there's another side to their story, one of violence and war. Neanderthals were likely skilled fighters and dangerous warriors, similar to Homo sapiens. If we look at them from a biological aspect, it is clear that Neanderthals, like other predatory land animals, were inherently territorial, particularly as they hunted in groups as cooperative big game hunters. Like lions, wolves, and Homo sapiens, they engaged in group hunting for survival. Predators that are on top of the food chain often contend with territorial disputes driven by overpopulation and competition for hunting grounds. Neanderthals were no different. If other species didn't control their numbers, violence and warfare over hunting territories would. Warfare is part of being human. It is not a recent innovation. War is an ancient and fundamental part of our humanity. Throughout history, all societies engaged in conflicts, and our earliest written records are filled with stories of wars. Archaeological findings unveil the remains of ancient fortresses, battlegrounds, and sites of prehistoric massacres that span thousands of years. Neanderthals are similar to modern humans in our skeletal autonomy, with a 99.7% DNA overlap. In terms of behavior, Neanderthals exhibited also astonishing similarity with Homo sapiens. They mastered fire, buried their dead, made jewelry from seashells and animal teeth, created art, and also erected stone shrines. Given these shared behaviors, it becomes most likely that they also shared comparable destructive instincts. The archaeological records reveal that Neanderthals' lives are marked by anything but peace. The Neanderthals were skilled big game hunters, utilizing spears to bring down prey, including deer, ibex, elk, bison, rhino, and mammoths. It is inconceivable to think that they would have hesitated to use these weapons when confronted with threats to their families or to their hunting grounds. The archaeological evidence strongly suggests that such conflicts were commonplace in the lives of Neanderthals. Neanderthal fossils show a significant numbers of broken arms. Most notably, there is evidence of a Neanderthal from Shanidar Cave in Iraq who suffered a spear impalement to his chest, with a glancing blow seen on one of his ribs. Instances of trauma were particularly prevalent among young Neanderthal males, often ending in their deaths. While some injuries may have originated from their hunting activities, the pattern found aligns more closely with what would have been seen in a population engaged in intertribal warfare, characterized by small-scale yet intense prolonged conflicts dominated by guerrilla-style raids and ambushes punctuated by occasional large-scale battles. Traces of war also show in the establishment of the territories of Neanderthals and Homo sapiens. The reason modern humans were not successful leaving Africa until 70,000 years ago could have been because Neanderthals fended off the invader and would not be dominated in their territories in Asia and Europe. Homo sapiens who left Africa earlier in northern Africa could have been pushed back or killed. For about 100,000 years, Neanderthals resisted Homo sapiens' expansion out of Africa. In contrast, Homo sapiens populated the Americas from the tip of North America to the tip of South America within just a few thousand years. The new arrivals to America had large predators, including the saber-toothed cat, lions, bears, and wolves to contend with, much like Europe and Asia. However, the expansion could only happen quickly because there was no contact with other established human species. This allowed them to dedicate their time and energy to the propagation of their species and expand into unknown territory without any risk of war. The idea that the presence of Neanderthals may have played a role in delaying the migration of Homo sapiens out of Africa is a hypothesis that has been discussed among scientists. However, it is important to note that this is just one of several factors that could have influenced the timing and pattern of human migration. Population growth inherently compels humans to seek additional land, ensuring adequate territory for hunting and gathering food. The possibility where modern humans encountered Neanderthals and chose a peaceful coexistence does not seem likely. Instead, over the course of thousands of years, it seems we continually tested the mettle of Neanderthal fighters, and for an extended period found ourselves on the losing side. In the realm of weaponry, tactics, and strategy, we appeared to be evenly matched adversaries. The Neanderthals likely held tactical and strategic advantages, already inhabiting the Middle East for hundreds of thousands of years. They gained keen knowledge of the landscape, seasonal changes, and how to survive on the plants and animals in the area. Their intimidating, muscular physiques would have rendered them formidable in close-quarter combat during battles. Additionally, their oversized eyes probably allowed the Neanderthals superior low-light vision, enabling skillful maneuvering in the dark for ambushes and dawn raids. However, eventually, the extended stalemate gave way, and the balance shifted. The precise reason for this turnaround remains unclear. It is conceivable that the introduction of superior range weapons, such as bows, spear throwers, and throwing clubs, allowed the more lightly built Homo sapiens to harass the robust Neanderthals from a distance, employing hit-and-run tactics. Alternatively, advancement in hunting and gathering techniques may have enabled Homo sapiens to sustain larger tribes, resulting in greater numbers during conflicts. Even after the emergence of primitive Homo sapiens from Africa 200,000 years ago, it required more than 150,000 years to assert dominance over the Neanderthals' territories. We were just not ready yet. In regions such as Israel and Greece, archaic Homo sapiens made territory gains only to face setbacks from Neanderthals' counteroffenses. It wasn't until a final offensive by modern Homo sapiens that commenced around 70 to 50,000 years ago that Neanderthals were eventually eliminated. Contrary to a swift and decisive blitzkrieg, this was a prolonged war of attrition. Ultimately, Homo sapiens emerged victorious, not because Neanderthals were declined to fight, but likely because we became more adept at the art of war over time, with better cooperation with unrelated individuals and advanced projectile weapons. Our next video will explore the DNA of Neanderthals and why they may have been overwhelmed by new diseases as well as war with modern humans. Please like and subscribe if you like more content like this.